Planet Earth is under threat. Thousands of wild animals are in danger of becoming extinct. CBBC has decided to find out what's being done to save them. Last year, CBBC launched a nationwide search to find some of our most passionate young wildlife experts. Two of the entries were Louis Jinks from Blackburn and Jack Common from Nottingham.
How does that feel, Louis?
Good. You know, kangaroos and wallabies, they can't fart.
The prize, a trip of a lifetime to see some of the most endangered species on the planet. It was tough, but in the end, only seven could go. Wildlife presenter Michaela Stacken helped choose the winners.
I'm here to tell you that all four of you are going.
On your yes! You've got a trip of a lifetime. Yes!
Well done. Give yourselves a round of applause. Yay!
Jack and Louis have won, and they're going together. This is their story.
I just jumped for joy, quite literally. It was such a good feeling.
It's too hard to explain. You can't explain it was that good a feeling.
Yes, I saw that.
We both love wildlife, but I suppose birds are my favourite.
I go birdwatching about twice a week. You never know what the birds are going to do, so it's always a surprise.
My biggest passion is probably birdwatching. They seem to almost have personalities.
We've been told we would be getting a message to tell us where we were going.
I was nervous but excited.
No, oh, it's a blue parrot thing.
You're going to Brazil.
Yes!
Oh my God.
You're going to Brazil to see the
hyacinth macaws
in the world's biggest wetland.
Oh wow.
Oh cool. I've always wanted to go there.
Never heard of hyacinth macaws, to be honest.
I have.
Wow.
We were going to the Pantanal in South America. It's the biggest wetland in the world, about the same size as Britain. It's home to nearly 700 different species of birds.
The hyacinth macaw is the largest parrot in the world. It's a metre long and can live up to 60 years of age. It only has one partner, which it mates with for life.
Many parrots are endangered because of their habitat being destroyed, but also because they're taken from the wild so that people can have them as pets. There are now only about 5,000 hyacinth macaws left in the wild.
It's a 12-hour flight to Brazil, but after a long journey, we finally arrived in the Pantanal.
Nearly there now.
There were hundreds of birds. It was amazing. Our list kept getting longer and longer.
Is it in this book, do you think? In about 10 minutes, I've seen 13 new species.
We'd seen loads of birds, but no hyacinth macaws. When we arrived at the lodge, there was a message waiting for us.
Oh, hello. Is that Jack and Louis? Nice to see you. This is Bill Oddie here.
I gather you...
You are off to Brazil to see hyacinth macaws. Fantastic.
Well done. Many congratulations. And I'll tell you something. I wish I was going with you. Oh, yeah.
Here's a little tip. If you're trying to find macaws, parrots or anything like that, use your ears. And chances are you'll hear them first, OK? Good luck.
You'll be easier than here anyway, I'll tell you. How's Sparrow? Over there.
Oh, whoa.
Welcome.
That was cool. It's weird. Like, the lady was talking to us.
I wasn't expecting that. We were both exhausted from the journey, but with so many birds to see, I just couldn't sleep.
It's red-crested cardinal. They're unique to the Pantanal. They're really beautiful. There's an ibis. It's a... buff-necked ibis, not the ones over there.
I'm really excited about seeing the hyacinth macaws. To see them in real life,
That would be so cool.
There used to be loads of hyacinth macaws in the Pantanal, but a few years ago the number dropped to only around 2,000.
Fortunately, people have set up projects to try and help them, and now the numbers are getting healthier.
They have to be looked after so that their numbers don't go back down again. Charlie Munn is a parrot expert, and he's offered to take me and Louie to see some of the nests they've been looking after.
Being a wetland, the Pantanal has areas of deep water, so to get to the nests, we had to ride a horse.
I've ridden before, so I was looking forward to it, but Louie had never been on a horse, so he was a bit nervous and couldn't really get started.
It's quite strange, actually, because it's like you can't control how it moves, because it's like not like a car, because it's alive, obviously. Oh, here we go, I think he's going. Oh, yeah, here we go.
Jack was really good, but after a couple of minutes, I got the hang of it too.
It's good, this. Best way to travel.
It was the nesting season, and that meant there were loads of vulnerable chicks around. Predators like monkeys can take them, but also illnesses can kill them. The scientists try and visit each nest every 2 or 3 days to check things are okay.
Hyacinths nest in mandiwi trees. They can be up to 8 metres high. To get to the nests, the scientists have to put up scaffolding.
Well, we figured with the scaffolding it would make the procedure much faster and even a little bit safer, handling the baby.
The research scientists had special permits that allowed them to handle the babies. They took them out of the nests and checked them over to make sure they were healthy and growing well.
Oh, that's tiny. Whoa. It looks quite strange.
There's a few feathers starting.
Looks like an alien.
They had to weigh them, measure the size of their beak, and check if they had any diseases.
How old would you guess this chick is?
Between 3 and 4 weeks old, probably.
Is that it? Mm-hmm. I didn't expect it to be this big.
Compared with the adults, it's actually really tiny, if you think, because the adults are like a metre tall. It hasn't even got its tail.
Does it look quite healthy to you?
The baby looks like it's in good condition and has no parasites, so that's excellent news.
Yeah, it's like relaxed, it's gone to sleep.
It's almost comatose.
I feel really privileged to go with biologists to look at the chick. It was quite ugly at first, but it was cute because it went to sleep. You could see the difference between the adults and when they first hatched.
It was great seeing the baby, but we really wanted to see an adult flying around.
On the way to the next nest, we heard an incredible noise. A pair of hyacinth macaws landed in the tree right next to us.
Oh, yes! Ooh. Hyacinth macaw.
That was nice, saying hello.
Bill Oddie was right. We heard them before we saw them.
They just came in with a huge flying blue ball of noise.
It's like really loud.
Squawky.
Penetrating call, isn't it? They're so big, they don't seem like they should be flying. I would reckon they're about a metre. I think they are a metre tall, so it's about there.
That is some big parrot.
That is huge.
It was amazing seeing our first wild hyacinth macaws.
Quite privileged actually, because it's like not very often you get to see such a rare animal.
Made my heart miss a beat. It was so exciting because I'd never seen any really endangered birds before.
There's loads of different animals living in the Pantanal, and on the way back to our lodge we were taken to a viewing platform high above the canopy.
There's a troop of black owl monkeys have just appeared in the trees and all come up to say hello, I think.
This little male took a shine to the camera.
I think they like water. They're amazing. I can't believe a wild owl monkey actually crawled on me. I don't think I'll ever forget that. That was
He's licking the camera now.
More and more howler monkeys kept arriving.
That's a female howler monkey. She's got a baby.
It's just unbelievable.
It's amazing.
Four
howler really close.
Five,
just right close to you, and they don't seem threatened in any way. Look, he's just lounging around, lying around and yawning.
Maybe because we're apes. Same family as him.
As the sun set, the monkeys seemed to get tired, but it'd been a brilliant day.
And everyone to go, it's... I just can't describe it, it's that great.
It was so amazing. I feel like I could cry, it's really quite emotional.
Never imagined it to be like this.
Macaw that called him right outside my bedroom.
We've been lucky to see so many macaws as they're extremely rare. One of their biggest threats is from nest robbers, taking the birds and then selling them on for pets. It was hard to believe that one of Charlie's helpers, Haimundo, used to rob nests for a living.
My father was a nest robber and I started taking birds when I was 12 years old. I'd go into the forest and cut down a tree to make a ladder. Then I would slowly make my way up to the nest and carefully take out the bird. It was dangerous work. Some nests could be as high as 20 meters. We would make around 70 pounds per cheek.
He told us that the birds would then be sent all over the world to be sold as pets. Louis and I went to a rescue center. They had hundreds of birds that had been illegally taken from the wild.
I think people having parrots as pets is really bad.
Imagine taking us from our homes and putting us in a cage for the rest of our life. It's horrible, the pet trade.
I always thought seeing a blue gold macaw in a cage was quite cool. But when you see them in the wild, it's just completely different. And with the hyacinths, they're absolutely stunning. I don't see why people would want to put them in cages.
Luckily, Haimundo has changed, and he now works for conservation, using his skills to help save hyacinth macaws.
They're endangered, so they need people like that to change into conservationists to stop taking them and start helping them.
If we got more people like Haimundo, the wild bird trade would decrease.
Well, let's take a look at this tree.
Looks like the nest up in this tree.
To be a good bird conservationist, you can't be afraid of heights. The chick in this nest was too big to take out, so Charlie asked us to go up and take a look.
I am a bit nervous about going up.
I'm nervous because, I don't know, I'm not particularly fond of heights really, but I'll be all right once I get up there.
Okay, ready? I'm going to test it.
Have fun.
It needs to be physically pushed?
Yeah.
Whoa. Okay, I think it's going to bite my hand.
What's going on, Jack? Can you see anything yet?
Oh, wow, I got it. From the head to, say, about the top of the wings, it's got full plumage. Very cool. Very, very, very cool. The noise is like a grating sort of guttural, like... like almost like a roar. It's a really cool noise. Okay, bring me down.
After seeing Jack, I was even more nervous.
I'm as ready as I'll ever be, I suppose.
Wish I was going up again. It's brilliant.
You're facing the wrong way, do we?
I'm the wrong way.
That looks a precarious position.
Where am I looking?
Right behind your head.
I'm quite confused.
There you go, mate.
Sorry.
thanks.
Oh, wow. Whoa. That is amazing.
I can see it. Its head is huge. I never expected it to be that big. It's massive.
Look at you. He's a pretty boy then.
Whoa. It's massive for a chick.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. That was fantastic. That's what it is, isn't it? It's a huge chick.
It's so cool. Really unbelievable. It's the best bit of the trip so far.
At the next nest, we got some unexpected visitors. A pair of blue and gold macaws came flying in.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Very rare in the Pantanal.
Very rare in the Pantanal.
They were soon joined by a load of hyacinths.
The reason why there's so many macaws around is because they're so intelligent. They actually come and investigate what's going on.
All the birds must have heard our chick because it was really, really noisy.
Oh my god. How cool is that? That's like...
He was slightly smaller than the chick we'd climbed up to see, so we could get a really good look at him.
They're measuring the culmen of the beak.
You can tell how old a bird is by the size of its beak. This chick was about 7 weeks old.
Its beak was soft at the moment, but if it was fully grown, it could have broken my finger off, as it has the strongest beak in the world.
This chick still had about 6 weeks to go before leaving the nest.
All this stuff has to fill in with feathers, and then the wing has to grow quite a bit, and then they have to practice flapping a lot, and then they'll make their first flight.
Is it doing all right then, this?
It looks like it's doing very well. Very well. Yeah, I think you're doing fine. Right?
I think we're very lucky. Very, very lucky.
I feel really privileged to come here and do what we're doing and help with the conservation.
Back at the lodge, I went out bird spotting, but the most exciting thing I saw wasn't a bird. There was a caiman really close to the bank.
There's a caiman just down there.
They're quite shy of people, so I wasn't really scared. And it did the most amazing thing right in front of me.
Oh my god.
Oh wow, that was cool.
He's doing it right there.
To attract females, males vibrate the water with their backs and then call loudly. I couldn't believe I'd seen such a rare thing.
On the way to the next nest, we could tell something was wrong. The scientist had some bad news for us.
It's dead.
Ah, really?
He says it's dead.
Ugh.
What a way to go. Kind of curious to take a look, even though it's grizzly.
They said the ants had invaded the nest and eaten the chick.
It's just like you can see a bit of white where the chick is, and then most of it's covered in ants.
Ugh.
And it smells. That's
gross.
I don't want to look anymore. I
know it was horrible, but I still wanted to take a look.
Is it horrible? It's not that bad.
How many ants are there?
I guess about 100,000.
2 out of 10 chicks die before leaving the nest. Charlie said that monkeys often steal the chicks, but it's really unusual for them to be killed by ants.
Because hyacinths are so endangered, they need every chick to survive.
And it just shows how vulnerable the chicks are when they're that young.
Bad way to go.
Yes, eaten alive by ants.
Yeah. That's not nice. Mm.
Thank you. Unfortunately, on the way home, I got something in my eye which meant I had to go to the doctor's.
I'm feeling a bit frustrated because my eye hasn't seemed to got better. I have to go to the doctor's and that's like a, from here it's about a 10-hour trip there and back.
When Jack left, I went off to see another big animal in the Pantanal. The Pantanal is home to the anaconda, the world's largest snake, the capybara, the world's largest rodent, and the animal I was going to see, the giant otter. They can grow to 2 metres in length. That's bigger than me. Like the hyacinth macaws, they're endangered. They were hunted for their skins and faced losing their homes because of deforestation and land being converted for grazing for cattle. Here in the Pantanal, people are trying to make money for conservation through ecotourism, attracting people to the area to look at wildlife. Otters are a big attraction and they love eating piranha fish. So I went fishing with Paulina, a local otter fan. They were really hard to catch and we had competition from a caiman. You have to have the knack, but after a while, I did catch a few.
Yes, I got one!
So did I.
Yes, yes.
The otters were used to the boats, so when they heard the engine, they came straight for us.
Look!
They definitely wanted food.
Oh, wow.
They're amazing. They're really big. I didn't expect them to be that big. They're huge.
It was a bit scary. They've got enormous teeth and they're bigger than me.
I think it is a good way of attracting people to the area, but it makes them less wild in a way because they can get used to eating fish and then they won't hunt as much, so they won't be as wild. So it's bad in a way and good in a way, really.
I realised that it's not just otters and hyacinths that need protecting. It's all the animals that live here. And if they don't have lots of tourists, there's not as much money to look after them and protect them. I really wanted to see a jaguar, but they're one of the hardest animals to see because they're shy and very rare. Part of the reason they're endangered is because some farmers shoot them when they've been eating their cattle. Mauricio used to shoot jaguars, but now he's using his skills to take tourists to go see them, and he's promised to take me. Jaguars are active at night, so that's the best time to go.
Oh, look, there's a caiman on the road. He's calling the jaguars with that instrument. Sometimes the jaguars will answer back. It's well cool.
There was no reply, but there was a footprint right next to the jeep. The jaguar was close.
Is it safe to go to the loo?
Then, all of a sudden, we got a reply. I couldn't believe I'd actually heard a jaguar.
That was well good. You could hear them, but you couldn't see them, so it was like mysterious, so they were really exciting. And it's just really cool how they made the noise and then you can hear it answering back. It was amazing, it was so good. It was really cool.
The next day, Jack was back, but we only had a couple of days before we went home. Just enough time to go check on our hyacinth chicks.
After seeing that chick eaten by ants, I was a little bit nervous about this one.
Ah, hello again. It's developed quite quickly, hasn't it?
I'm glad to see it's all right.
The baby had lost a bit of weight, but it had just done a poo.
It must be a heavy poo if it's decreased its weight by 100 grams.
Despite the weight loss, the baby was doing fine, which is great news because every chick needs to survive. But when we went to the bigger chick, it was really quiet.
Oh, yeah.
I hope that's not bad
news. Yeah, so do I.
Luckily, it soon started squawking.
The Costa. Wow. Tito Baldi? Oh, no. Tito Baldi?
Okay. Has he got a clean bill of health, as you said last time?
These chicks were doing all right, but only because certain people were starting to look after them.
Definitely my favourite bird.
Even though we were going home, we still wanted to carry on helping the macaws.
Charlie told us that you can adopt parts of the pantanal to conserve the wildlife.
I think I'm going to save it for somebody and buy a bit.
I'd like one with a nice lot of tree cavities and hyacinths nesting in it, and when I visit it, they'll be all flying around my head and landing on my shoulders or something.
Around the world, thousands of animals are becoming extinct. But with projects like this, I think we've got a good chance of saving some of our most endangered species.
We've had an absolutely fantastically brilliant time. We're never going to forget it, and it's just going to... This is the best thing I've ever done, ever.
And me.
Oh, look! Macaws!
Oh, wow!
Oh, cool!
They've come to say goodbye.
Yeah. Giving us an air show.